Folks, welcome back to Magnus's Loot Crate. I am your host, as always, Magnus Deacon. Now, folks, before we get into this one, I do have to bring up, this one took a while to come out, and I do have to give a little bit of backstory. This started out as the Zeta Toys Core Star. Now, there was a little bit of a cease and desist action going on with Takara, actually specifically HasLab, where they were making their own version of Unicron, and they told Zeta Toys not to cut it, so Zeta Toys said, okay, we'll back off for now. But folks, like I told everybody, and this is the happiest I told you so that I've ever had, I told people, just wait, it'll still happen. And folks, we have 01 Studio Cell. Now, folks, like I said, this one's been a while in the making, and I'm happy to get to it. So, folks, let's just go ahead and dive right into it. Folks, here we have the clamshell for Studio 01 Cell. Now, just as an aside, I had to just take a picture and stretch that out because I couldn't use the turntable because, well, the bottom of his clamshell was too weak to stand on the turntable, but that's all right because this actually gives me more of a chance to show you what actually comes in the box with him and the secondary box, which we'll get into, that comes with the head and the wings. Now, folks, that's everything he comes with. He does have some bags with him. I'll show you the contents of those a little bit later on. But for right now, let's just suffice it to say, this is everything you get with Studio 01 Cell. Now, folks, we're going to go ahead and take a look at his planet mode.
You exaggerate.
So, folks, here is Studio 01 Cell in his planet mode. My goodness, that thing is a bowling ball, folks. I can tell you that right now. Now, I'll go into a little bit more detail about the stands and the bits and pieces you see on him. I'm going to go ahead and say it just so you know. I don't have every little piece put on him in this video, and I don't even have it all put on him in his bot mode. But suffice it to say, he looks really good. He fits the animation model that you've seen in the very earlier part of the video very well. He looks really good. And he's definitely a piece that's worth having in your collection. I can go ahead and say that right now. He's a good bot. He's heavy, hefty, and like I said, I'm going to do the up close and personal later on in the video, but suffice it to say, you will get to see the up close and personal because now, folks, we're going to move on and take a look at bits and bobs, and then we'll do the big reveal. So, folks, now that we've seen the planet mode, I'm going to save the up close and personal till after the big reveal like they did in the movie because why would you? But folks, I am going to show you some of the things he comes with. One thing he comes with is this box. Now this is the box that's the special bonus material that contains his wings, planetary rings, and his head. And it's a gorgeous head sculpt, but well, I'll save that for later. He comes with two of these. Now these are both two pieces. You can put these together. He's got a hole in the middle of this. As you can see, they come apart. This is a piece that can double as a sort of a stand. Both of these pieces can double as a stand, and if you put them back together, his little suction field that he uses for his planet mode when he's going to eat something. Now, folks, I do have to tell you, he comes with a compartment on the back of his head. You can put two LR44 batteries in there. His eyes will light up, but it also has, on the top of his head, has a little light that will shine directly through this hole in the back of this and light this up and make it look like he's trying to suck things in. Now, I don't have any batteries with me, so I can't show you that. It also comes with a couple of other things. It comes with this bag full of goodies. These are differently colored pieces where you can swap out and change, you know, the color of certain parts like his forearms and things. I'm just going to leave mine as is, so that's what you're going to see on the turntable. He also comes with this screwdriver. As I've told you guys before, one of my favorite accessories that comes with things like this. But he also comes with a couple of sprues. And I'm going to warn you about these. He also comes with a few sprues with little bits that you can hook on to his planet mode. And they'll bend up and down. You know, they're... I don't know if you can see it that well. But they're C-clips. They'll clip on to like his shoulders or his forearms and things like that. And you can fold them out and make the spikes on his robot mode. Be careful with those. Now, I don't think I have all of them placed on mine. I'm not that worried about it because he looks gorgeous even with just a few I put on. He also does come with screw hole covers so that you can cover up like different holes, because when I put the screw hole covers in on mine, the screw on the one would be on the front of the thigh and then the other one would be on the back of the other leg. So folks, keep that in mind when you're putting the screw hole covers on. But folks, you know what, I've talked about this enough. Let's go ahead, transform him up, and take a look at that robot mode.
You underestimate me, Galvatron.
Folks, there he is, the Planet Eater, the Chaos Bringer, any of a number of epithets or titles he's earned over the decades. Folks, it's the one and only Unicron himself. Folks, I really, really like this guy. He's nice and hefty. He's got really strong joints, so he can hold just about any pose you put him in. I've even seen a picture. I wish I could find it. If somebody knows where it is, please send it to me. There's a picture of this guy doing a one-handed handstand. So he's strong and he can hold just about any kind of pose you can put him in. Folks, he's also very good looking. He's not as big as a lot of people probably would have liked him to be, me included. But I can honestly say I really am happy with this purchase. I can't say that I'm sorry I spent the money for this guy. He is definitely a great looking bot. So folks, now you've been waiting for this, let's go ahead and get up close and personal.
For a time, we considered sparing a wretched little planet Cybertron. But now, we shall witness it's dismemberment.
No! Folks, here we are, up close and personal with Studio 01 Cell. Now that is a gorgeous looking face sculpt. He's standing on my leg, so he is a pretty big boy. His horns kind of move around. And folks, as you can see here, he can open his mouth. He can do all kinds of poses. I've seen pictures of this guy doing a single hand handstand. But folks, this is it. This is the one we've kind of been waiting for quite a while. And his wings can move up and down on his shoulders. Like I was talking about before, if you look here, you can stand up or sit down, and be careful, because they could be really easy to lose because they're decently tight C-clips, but you can lose them if you're not careful. But folks, just look at this guy. He is a nice one. And honestly, folks, For $400, I think I backed the right horse on this one, because I was thinking about getting the HasLab Unicron. When I saw this guy, I was like, nah, I do kind of regret that he's not bigger. I know. If he were bigger, that would make it harder to keep him around. But folks, I'm going to tell you right now, he's got individually articulated fingers. Like you've seen here, these little pieces can be stood straight up. And even the ones on his forearms here can stick out like they did in the movie. Folks, I'm going to tell you right now, he's definitely worth the money. So folks, that's it for this Magnus's Loot Crate review. Folks, I tell you what, we're going to go ahead and take a look at the final verdict, and I will see you next time.
Has the Imperial Magistrate reached a verdict? I have.
Find these figures and more at Show Z Store. Links in the description.